Murrelektronik aim to specialise in decentralised installation. It's all about eliminating wiring time and installation time. The idea behind that is not to eliminate jobs or roles within companies, it's to enable us to make more projects per year and have a higher output from each staff member. Now, the design of all of these products is focused in one way or another on universal interface and speeding up the process of installation and commissioning. Starting off in the panel, where everyone's most comfortable, we have what's called Cube 20. Now with Cube 20, we have a ribbon cable system to interface between one module and the next. And with this system here, you have a range of different interface units, a range of different I/O modules, and then in this case we actually have the ability to then talk into the field on Cube 67 with a Cube 20 to 67 interface. Each I/O point on this is short circuit and overload protected. It was one of our first I/O products to do so. It has LED indicators for red for fault, yellow for on and active, and it has good power banks on each point for 24 volt distribution. We also have Cube 20S. Now this is our most flexible interface unit because we have more protocols on this specific side of the Cube 20S system than any other I/O product we have on market currently. The safety is only available on ProfiSafe, ProfiNet and Siemens systems, and they work very well when combined with our Exact 8, Exact 12, and this is the Exact 12 with a removable cap. Now, Exact 8 and Exact 12 are standalone in terms of passive distribution because there is a internal PCB as opposed to being mounted inside a plastic housing and then backfilled for potting compound. We actually just mould the complete unit around the PCB and the internal plastic system. With the removable cap version, there is a new feature coming called LogiCap. That is where we have the ability to use AND, NAND or XOR gates to combine inputs or trigger outputs from inputs, etc. within the cap with a programmable function on the front. It's going to be available very soon. We then also have MVK Safety, which is our most successful safety product, selling hundreds within the automotive industry. We have input and outputs on one unit, or on the alternative module, there is all inputs across all ports. ProfiSafe address setting in the front, 7/8 power communication in, and Ethernet M12 into that. We have the ability to work with OSSD or contact-based systems, so that each one, when the guard is simulated, is dropped, removes the LEDs here, and we're just using our new machine light to signal the fact that that's on or off in safe or unsafe mode. We then also have a range of e-stops with reset buttons or lamps, e-stops without, or a more classically sized e-stop, each with an M12 interface to control the contacts and trigger the inputs, outputs, push buttons, etc., all of which are dual channel. These modules are particularly nice at 40mm width because they fit perfectly onto aluminium extrusion and even come with a pack of T-slots and T-nuts with them when you purchase them. With this in mind from the safety point of view, we also have the e-stops fed. This one's into that unit there. This one drops out that unit there and cuts the power. And this one triggers that one and drops that up as needed within the program. Then moving on to one of my favourite products from Murrelektronik from a field bus point of view, Cube 67. Now Cube 67 works in the same way as we're used to all remote I/O units working. There is an interface unit and an interface unit. There is a power module, in there is a power module. And then we have a distributed backplane. Now where with things such as the Cube 20 and the Cube 20S have a communication between connections there, or the ribbon cable. We've decided to go with a 6-pole N12 connection that includes your sensor power, actuator power, and communication within the system in a single cable. So that can be buried within the aluminium extrusion, or very, very minimal wiring to do a full distributed system. I'm not saying that for a machine only 2 meters across, this is ideal. This is more for medium to large machines. Conveyor jobs where it's hundreds of meters, again, it's not really applicable, but as part of the applications team, what we can do is come and assess each project that you look at and find the best solution for you. Whether that's cost, whether it's features, functions, eliminating wiring time, we can do calculations to figure out the number of wiring points you'll need, what the cable cost will be, and it will be all inclusive with a layout drawing, etc. That's the same for any of our iron products, including the compact modules like the MVK, such as the Impact 67 or the MVK standard. With the cube system, we have a wide range of interface modules. So here we can see the K3 safety module. These are all standard outputs from the normal communication, but each bank has galvanic isolation. So with this one, we've got two zones, six outputs on each. And the power for those is fed through the M12 connector. In there is both positive and negative for bank one, and positive and negative for bank two. By pressing this e-stop here, you can see that just the left-hand bank shuts down and is now deactivated and considered safe. If we press this e-stop here, both banks completely shut down, and that's done through the wiring in the back. We then have IO link ports with DIO ports on there also. So we've got on that unit, we've got 4 IO link masters and 12 configurable DIO units. Using our IO link hubs, with specifically with this module, the K3, we have the same features as here. Full galvanic isolation between the inputs and the outputs, so that the IO link communication is done through the grey cable, and the safe voltage for the outputs is fed through yellow cable, as we can see there. So as we press, it shuts down that entire side and makes all outputs considered safe. We then have a range of valve terminals. Now these come with the classic 25 pin, 16 pin or 32 pin D-sub connectors for any type of pneumatic valve bank or valve manifold you may have. So we cater for all the major suppliers, so Bosch, Mack, Norgren, SMC, Festo, and others. We also have a communication direct to the Modlite Pro system, or just open-ended cable ready for wiring. Then we have the specialist modules. So with these modules, these are food and beverage. With that, you can see that they're full stainless steel design, IP69K, and come in the slimline, the large, or an IO link enabled module as well, with 4, again, the same principle as this, 4 IO link masters, 12 DIO. With it being food and beverage, we have Ecolab and FDA approval so that it's ready for pharma or food. And in doing so, we have to use the Food and Beverage Pro cable range. Now with that, it's polypropylene as opposed to PUR, because the PUR has a very large number of small pits across the cable. With this, it's much smoother and much easier to jet wash down, including a range of stainless blanking caps for the front. We also do, in the food and beverage range, the MVP Extreme, which is a stainless steel version of this body with an interface on the top and the correct cable going out the back.